Nassau grouper is a coral reef fish that's found throughout the tropical western Atlantic, and it's pretty common in the Bahamas.
The Nassau grouper used to be among the most important fishery in the wider Caribbean, but unfortunately over the last several decades, it's been depleted and overfished.
Over the last 30 years, numbers have drastically declined. A lot of fishermen and communities benefit from harvesting Nassau grouper.
One of the reasons why it's been overfished is because the Nassau grouper has a real interesting and cool way that it reproduces, and that's in large aggregations called fish spawning aggregations. And the reason why these fish do this is because if you're normally solitary on a reef, you can't find a mate. So these fish will swim from hundreds of miles around to the same reef every year on the full moon in December and January predominantly in order to find mates.
In the days leading up to the full moon, we see a lot of courtship behavior, so fish changing colors, nudging, chasing. As the sun sets leading up to the night of the full moon, that's when all the activity is happening. And you have fish breaking off to the surface, releasing their eggs and sperm, and then joining the school again. They go back to their home reefs. And that's it for the year. It only happens once a year.
But unfortunately, because it's so predictable, the fishermen can come to that same spot year in and year out, they drop their traps, and they catch hundreds of fish. Which is wonderful for them, not so wonderful for the fish themselves. And so unfortunately, they are being over-harvested, not only within that small region, but throughout hundreds of miles of ocean.
Historically, Nassau grouper were so healthy that a lot of these spawning aggregation sites used to have between 30,000 to 100,000 grouper. But today, typically the aggregations have between hundreds to thousands of individuals.
So Shedd Aquarium and our partners are conducting research that will be applied directly to a science-based management strategy for the fishery. We're using our research vessel, which is a wonderful resource that's based out of Miami, in order to visit these spawning aggregations that are very challenging to get to because they occur in very remote areas.
This project is using a suite of methods to understand Nassau grouper spawning aggregations. And one of those methods is acoustic telemetry. And what that involves is we put out an array of receivers. They're bottom monitors that are able to detect movement patterns of fish once they have been implanted with an acoustic transmitter that picks up the signal from those bottom monitors. Outside of the spawning season, obviously the fish is solitary, so what we have to do to collect fish is dive. So we rotate teams in and out of the water throughout the day, and we search the reef until we find a grouper. Hopefully we catch it, and then we slowly bring it to the surface. The boat is equipped with a live well, which is perfect for working up fish. So once the fish is on board and has recovered, we tag it with an external tag, which is called a Floy tag, and each of those tags are color-coded for each island in the Bahamas. We then measure the fish, we take two length measurements, we also weigh the fish, and then take a fin clip sample for genetics, a blood sample, and if it's the appropriate size fish, it's put under anesthesia. Once it's sleeping, then it gets transferred to a surgery cooler where it gets surgically implanted with a tiny acoustic transmitter. That gets sutured and then the fish is allowed to recover in the live well. Once it's swimming properly, then we personally escort it back down to the reef that it was caught from and make sure it's fine, let it go. So we're able to take a good bit of info from these fish. What we have is an array of receivers along the continental shelf of Andres, which happens to be the third largest barrier reef in the world. And we also have a system set up in Long Island at one of the spawning aggregation sites to understand movement patterns of fish within a spawning aggregation.
So we can then better understand, do we need to protect just that spawning aggregation, or do we also need to protect their travel migration pathways to and from these spawning aggregations? We realize this fishery is critically important, not only from a commercial value, it provides livelihoods, it's also important from a social perspective. The capital of the Bahamas is named Nassau. The Nassau grouper is named after the capital. So it's critically important that we save this fishery, not just for the fish, not just for the reefs that they live on, but again, for the people. Now we're still in the process of conducting the research and analyzing the results, but what we do know is that Shedd Aquarium will be with our Bahamian colleagues every step of the way to ensure that their fisheries are protected for future generations.